Hi, and welcome to the next installment of our technical overview videos in our partner innovation video series. My name is Sergio Ortega, and I'm part of the Azure IoT engineering team. I drive go-to-market and business development for Azure PlugandPlay and Edge aggregators. Omnio is a key partner in this space. Today, we're talking with Mikkel Sorensen, founder of Omnio, about their Omnio Edge solution. We're very excited to have Mikkel here and the opportunity to drill down into their solution. Let's start with an introduction.
Hi, thanks Sergio. I'm very happy to be here with you today. My name is Mikkel Sorensen and I'm the founder and CEO of Omnio. We started Omnio to help companies get value from industrial IoT, and one of the main problems is getting unified data from their industrial assets. Trust me, I know. I was once one of these big companies trying to get information and unified data out of my industrial assets, and it wasn't easy. But here, four years in, we are proud to be here to explain how Omnio Edge solves this problem for Azure IoT plug-and-play customers.
So Mikkel, tell us about Omnio Edge solution. What technical value does it bring to customers?
Yeah, good. Yeah, any industrial IoT project requires good, unified data to work. It's plainly the foundation, right? It's all about converging the OT equipment with the IT side, which can be extremely complex and time-consuming. Now, Omnio Edge is a piece of software that creates a single unified data layer, making it fast and easy to extract unified data from industrial assets. Well, if you want to extract data from devices, especially unified data, like from PLCs, OBC UA servers, or standardized devices, you need a few things. You need a protocol stack, like maybe a Modbus stack or something similar. You need device connectors that document exactly how the unique device structures and communicates its data. And then you need a layer to unify this data before it hits the IT side, so it's not just one big mess of inconcurrent data. Now, normally you would have to find a stack first and install it, build a device connector by reading the manual, and you have to do that for each device. And then once you get the data out, you have to realize, wait a minute, this is pretty messy, it looks very different. And then you have to build this unification layer or data mapping on top of it, before you can feed it into UI, AI, or just simply storage, right? Now, Omnio Edge is a no-code solution that solves that entire problem stack with a simple UI that you use for configuring the software, more than 60,000 pre-built device connectors, and an automated unification layer, all wrapped in a small Docker container. In practice, Omnio Edge runs on the edge, extracting data from thousands of devices we support. It instantly unifies it and delivers it to the destination. By unifying it already at the edge, it means that we are able to support edge analytics, local HMIs, or even SCADA applications in the same location at the same time as it goes to the cloud, so you have one version of the truth. The application layer and the analytics and all that wonderful stuff that creates a lot of value is out of our hands, because we don't really work with that. We're a specialized company that works as a unified data layer. But once you have that unified data, you can get started and build an application that will scale on either on Azure or in IoT Central, and it's all up to you.
Thanks, Mikkel. It will be great to see Omnio Edge in action. But before that, can you give us an idea of some of the use cases?
Yeah, certainly. So Omnio Edge really is a horizontal infrastructure layer that can be used across a lot of different use cases. Some of the popular ones we see are things like energy management, predictive maintenance, condition monitoring, and digital twins. So if you want to build and scale solutions like that, but you don't want to spend your time on the time-consuming integration and data mapping, you should definitely try Omnio Edge.
These are such great examples that fit many different customer scenarios. Can you share a customer story? And I would love to see as well a demonstration of Omnio Edge.
Yeah, sure. So we actually did a case with a customer that needed to monitor both their production lines and their HVAC equipment in the factory. The goal was to both do energy management and predictive maintenance, which is a pretty tall order with a lot of devices in the mix. On the day, we deployed Omnio Edge during the lunch break on the production floor. And basically, they went from 0 to 300 million data points per day in 30 minutes. We streamed the data directly into the IoT hub, and from there, the data science could start. Because the data was all unified, they could immediately start finding improvements across the production in spite of their fairly complex device mix. And now, with Omnio, with IoT plug and play, it's even easier. but I guess you'd rather see it than hear me talk about it, right? In this demo, I'll show you how to connect the Siemens PAC4200, that's a power meter, to Azure IoT, generate the DTDL device model, and review the data. Let's get started. First, we're here in Omnio's config UI, and I've created a configuration called Azure Demo. Now let's add an endpoint, which will be in Azure IoT Hub. Click Next, where we'll just add our connection string. We could also choose to use an IoT Edge, but not this time. Click Finish. Time to add a device. We search for Siemens to find the Siemens PAC4200. We go to Configure Protocol. We give the device a label so we can find it in the IoT Hub. 4200 demo. Put in the IP address. And choose some data. We'll just choose all of it. This little Omnio logo here means that it's standardized data, so I can trust it'll always be the same no matter which power meter I connect. I set up the frequency to get data every second. Click Finish, click Save and Deploy, and now the configuration is saved. So now all I have to do is grab this Docker string and go execute it on my gateway, and I'll start getting data. Now we're on the gateway. This is a Ubuntu gateway, could be another Linux, could be Windows 10. The important thing is that there's Docker, so we just paste our Docker command we copied from the configuration UI, and we click enter. It'll download everything, it'll start up, it'll connect, and it'll start sending data. Now it's time to review the data. We go to the 4200 demo device that we just created, and first we review the device twin, which is filled out with reported properties and everything. All right, let's go to IoT plug-and-play components. Let it resolve the model ID on the Omnio APIs. We can go into the device, see the full interface description in DTDL, review the properties, or look at some telemetry. Let's start the telemetry. There you go. There's a fresh batch of telemetry coming through. This is the raw JSON payload, but we can also see it as a modeled event where it is passed according to the DTDL compliant device model. And from here on in, all about making use of the data, storing it, using it for machine learning, using it for AI, or simply showing it in a nice UI. Everything's up to you. We've taken the data, we've unified it, we've delivered it according to a DTDL compliant device model, and you're good to go.
Thanks, Miko. That was an awesome demo. And I can immediately see how customers will find value deploying Omnio in their environment. Let's walk through the solution reference architecture. And I would love if you could address a question that I have, which is, what happens if a device is not in your catalog or is not supported?
Yeah, absolutely. Let's look a little bit under the hood here, right? The architecture is actually very simple by design. So say we have a typical site with devices, PLCs, and OPC UA servers. And now you want to get unified data from those assets into Azure IoT using Azure IoT Plug and Play. Now, Omnio Edge is at the center of it all, but it only works with a configuration like you saw in the demo. For that, we have the Omnio Cloud that runs in Azure, and it contains all our device connectors and our API service that allows the user to create configuration either in our UI or they can build their own, right? So if you're a big company and you don't want to use our UI, you can build your own for it. That's absolutely okay. And again, Omnio Edge runs on the edge, right? So it needs to be deployed on some sort of computer equipment on site. We support a lot of different topologies and concepts like Windows or Linux is completely open for us. Intel or ARM architecture is completely open as well. And we can also run in both online and completely offline scenarios for maximum security in, for instance, critical infrastructure. Now, once the software then starts up, it extracts data, unifies it at the edge, and delivers it either to the Edge Hub or the IoT Hub. And we can also send commands the other way back. But as default, that's not active as a security precaution. Now, once the data arrives in Azure IoT Hub or IoT Central, you can use the Digital Twins model parser to parse the data and feed it to your storage or application. That is possible because Omnio Edge on the fly actually creates a fully compliant, DTDL compliant device model and device twin that can be used across Azure IoT. Now, what if you needed to connect a device, but you can't find it in our catalog, right? That's a common question, and also for you, Sergio, right? And we have built some very specific tools for that exact challenge. And all you have to do is inform us what you want. We have a standard form for that, and we will add it and unify the data on request in a matter of days, so you can just connect it effortlessly with a fully DTDL compliant device model and everything.
Thank you, Mikhail. That's amazing. Can you talk about Azure PlugandPlay DTDL, that is our digital twin description language, and how it fits and interacts with Omnio Edge?
Yeah, certainly. So with Omnio Edge and Azure IoT PlugandPlay, the automation and capability to converge OT and IT is taken to a whole new level. It basically automatically allows you to describe the devices in a standardized way all the way from the edge and through your entire infrastructure. And this will in turn accelerate configuration and rollouts and give a shortened time to value, especially in brownfield scenarios. It helps with avoiding the custom integration unification work, saving often weeks of development work, maybe even years. It automates the connectivity, validation, and authentication to Azure. It gives improved device lifecycle management. And moreover, Omnio adds 60,000 devices to the Microsoft device catalog, allowing Microsoft customers to automatically connect these devices. And those devices are from all the big manufacturers, Siemens, ABB, GE, Eaton, you name it, we have it. And not only those devices, but also PLCs or OPC UA servers that you may already have in your sites today. If they're connected through Omnio Edge, they will all be unified and DTDL compliant too. So we'll basically also create the device model for even customized data sources. And that basically means a seamless integration to digital twins based on DTDL across the board. At the end, it works with all layers to enable value for the users through simplicity and ease of use.
These are great points, Mikko. So in closing, give me your elevator speech on how Omnio Edge solves the technical challenge of our customers.
Yeah, so we know what the challenge is because we experience it ourselves. So we built the unified data layer that solves this through ease of use, unification, and now the integration with Azure IoT PlugandPlay. That means that you get a fully DTDL compliant device model immediately, so you can keep using your data and instantly use it across the Azure IoT landscape.
Perfect. Well, Mikko, thank you for showing us this great solution that I think will accelerate deployment in IoT projects and eliminate a lot of the complexity that many of them face nowadays. I really appreciate your time today.
Thank you very much for having me. Look forward to working with you in the future.